Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Ableton Live 11, a complete DAW software that you can use to start making your own music. In just 12 minutes, we will see everything you need to learn and use it straight away. Ableton Live is a very unique DAW in its general workflow, offering two ways to make music, the session view and the arrangement view. You can switch between these with the buttons on the right side. You usually start with the session view, which is very useful to make experiments and comparisons, being loop-oriented. Then you switch to the arrangement view to make samples and music in time, ready to be rendered and exported. Despite these views seem very different, properties and options we will see are identical. We will start discovering the session view first. You also have several useful panels around that you can close and reopen with the arrow buttons. Between these, there is the info view panel that gives lots of useful help and hints on what you are hovering with your mouse cursor. First of all, import audio sample files by dragging and dropping these directly into Ableton from your computer or the browser panel on the left under the sample section. These are shown as colored blocks called clips, complete with their file name and collected under columns representing the audio tracks. Whereas to remove any clip, click on it to select it and use the backspace key. The session view is the best place to find the right sound. You can play back any clip with its play button. This can be played once or in loop multiple times, showing the loop cycles in bars at the bottom. Ableton allows to play back only one clip per column or track at the same time, so that you can change the clip to be played from each track to find the best option immediately. You can also play back an entire row by using the play button on the master track on the right. To stop the playback from any track, click on any stop button on it, or use stop button above to stop everything. To record from your microphone or any external instrument, just open the I/O section and set the correct input source under audio form. Then arm the track at the bottom and click any record button above to start recording on the selected cell. You can also put any other track in playback without recording these. Click again on the same record button to stop recording. Double-click on any clip to manage its properties at the bottom. You can check its audio waveform, turn on or off any warp or loop on it. With warp, you can adjust the speed rate under BPM. Or double-click within the dark line to drop yellow markers and customize the speed rate in time. With loop enabled, you can resize the top region to select the part of the waveform to be looped. Next to warp, you can also adjust the semitones and synths to tune the clip pitch. Now let's see how to work and compose MIDI files. You can import any MIDI file you have, or drag from the browser panel under Clips and Grooves. MIDI files are shown as clips under MIDI tracks and cannot be imported on audio tracks at all. You can also compose from zero by double-clicking on any vacant MIDI cell. At first, these MIDI tracks do not sound, since they miss any sample or instrument to use. In this video, we will see how to add digital instruments only. Double-click on any clip to open it at the bottom, and switch to the track panel to drag and drop any sample file or any from the samples section. You can also import drums, melodies, or complex synthesizers under Sounds, Drums, and Instruments. At this point, you can put the clip in loop and adjust the output sound by listening to its notes inside the piano roll next to the track panel. When you are ready, enable the draw tool in the top right corner and click on the piano roll to drop notes. These follow the grid unless you hold down the Alt or Command key to avoid snappings. Click on the notes to remove these instead. At the bottom, pull up and down the velocity point for each note, adjusting their loudness level. Now let's see how to manage these tracks. Right-click on these to cut, copy, rename, or remove. You can also create new audio, MIDI, or return tracks that we will see shortly. Below the clips list, you have several options to manage the sound from the track. They can be shown or hidden with the buttons on the right. You can also set the input and the output sources for the track and tune the send knobs to send part of the track sound to either the A or B return tracks on the right, used to mix sound together. At the bottom, you have the decibel meter with a marker that you can use to adjust the volume, especially if this reaches red, distorted levels. You can also use the pan knob to balance the left and the right stereo outputs and the track number to mute or unmute the current track. Below, click on the solo button to mute all the other tracks except the current one. Part of these options are present on the master track as well, with the difference that here you will affect the overall sound from the project. In addition, you can open the track panel to add special effects. On audio tracks, you can drop any equalizer, modulation, reverb, saturation, and more from the audio effects section. Adjusting properties and turning them on and off with the yellow button in the top left corner. These effects compose a side chain where the final sound is changed by following its order from the left to the right. You can click and drag any effect to place it in the correct order. On MIDI tracks, you can import audio effects after the sample or instrument used, and also MIDI effects before the notes become sound. Now let's see how to work with the arrangement view. This gets the same tracks seen on the session view and a complete timeline measured in bars and beats above and in seconds at the bottom. This view is also independent from the session view since this starts completely vacant, even if you have the session view full with clips. You can drop any file from your computer or the browser on the left. These clips are shown with their name and their waveform or notes through time within audio or MIDI tracks. You can see that the track and the clip options are identical to what we have seen for the session view. You can also import the work you have made on the session view. First of all, click on the timeline to fix the blue marker in time, representing the starting point of your next playback. Then, switch to the session view and use the record button on top. This will record on the arrangement timeline anything you play back from the session view live until you stop recording with the same record button. The clips recorded on the arrangement view are the same ones and within the same tracks used on the session view. To play back the content of the arrangement view, make sure to click on the Back to Arrangement button first to avoid the clips inside the session view, and then use the Play button on top or click above the timeline. A black marker indicates the current position and time, shown in bars and beats above. On the left side, adjust the tempo to set the speed rate of the project in beats per minute and also the time signature. On top, you can move and resize the Navigator to check the arrangement content or zoom over it. Pay attention when you come back to the session view. Whenever you play clips from the session view, you also play back the main timeline, resulting in getting other clips in play according to the arrangement view content. To edit any clip within the timeline, just click on it and drag it to move it in time or in other tracks. Also, hold down the Alt or Command key to avoid any snappings to the grid. Use Control or Command and X, C, and V to cut, copy, or paste the selected clip, holding down the Alt key to select just parts of it to cut and copy. You can remove any selected clip with the Backspace key. To undo any bad action, use Control or Command and Z anytime. To save your project, go to File and then to Save Live Set As. Ableton saves all projects under .als format, saving anything you have from both the session and the arrangement views. Whereas to render and export the final sound, go to File and then to Export Audio Video. On top, choose the master track to render the sound coming from all your tracks within a time range defined by the loop region above the arrangement timeline. Below, set the sample rate to use, the file type, and the bit depth. Then, just go to export. Thank you for watching this super short guide. Don't forget to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to learn more and enhance your skills.